ago. So this is yesterday's. On to today. This is the last day in the sketchbook. Nope, still got a few more days in the sketchbook. 2253. So, I said at the end of yesterday, I'm going to move slightly down the street. Slightly different view. So see the detail of the actual building, if it wouldn't matter. I'm not guessing. But yeah, back to the Vernon Hall. If I ever teach another class, it probably will be in here. I don't know. I like somewhere light and bright. I've taught art classes before. I used to trained as an art teacher, ironically, considering I never did. Before, when I was an art teacher, I never would draw that much in front of pupils. One, didn't feel confident. Two, all my students were better at drawing than me at the time. And three, we didn't teach that way in the department I did my teacher training. So, my teacher training was at local sixth form. Told that teaching skills and techniques is for high school, and we do not teach that. First day I turned up on placement, to that particular college, I was asked, what skill are you not very good at that you wanted to come here to teach art? And my response is, pottery. I'm actually good at making pottery. What I'm not good at is selling pottery. That's still true today. I'm not, like a lot of artists, sales isn't my forte. them to come first with me. If they don't want to talk, they don't want to talk. It's fine. They've come to look around. My work's weird. It's finding that balance in between the selling person, between say hello, but beyond that, if they're not interested, if they're interested and they look like they're interested, and you'll talk to them, but otherwise, a lot of time affairs, people just want to come and have a look around and just say hello. Postcards that people could take away. I wouldn't take my word for it. I'd listen to someone who, you know, sells the word more often. I like, when I go to places, I like going up to people talking to them about the work. But that's me. Weird. Or as my Kieran used to say, I'm not weird, I'm gifted. Started. Line up, keep going. A brief cut as well. I'll swap batteries. I need to get a constant battery so I can just say, replace some of the blah blah with some music and record a separate blah blah blah. I don't know. When people start watching this, maybe they can say whether they prefer blah blah blah. Just music, or just the scratch, scratch, scratch in the pen. Marsh Mill in the background here, which is the first pottery shop we had. It was next to the Marsh Mill, on this block of shops. Actually next to the marshmallow itself. It's a little marshmallow village. With parking. And they just opened the Tesco Express there. So we've made made the mistake of getting a card machine. Those things cost a bloody fortune to keep up with the phone line. If I did it again, I wouldn't get that card machine. Just in my experience, I feel like the Zettel is perfect. Don't have the fixed monthly fees. It works along with your mobile phone. And I've used them out and about at fairs. And when I've had studio visits here. But at the time, I probably would have decided cash only, and the cash machine is just there. But when we first looked, we got. Actually got approved for a card reader, but it wasn't a mobile one or anything, it was just tied to the shop. We got approved for it when we first started, which was before we'd secured the shop unit. So as soon as we had the shop, they started charging us. Like I say, if I did it again, I would have saved the money. Cash only. Because we barely used the bullet bank for that year. Just a way of spending money. At the time, 2010, a lot of businesses still didn't have card readers. A lot of people still used cash. Then, you know, I was young, inexperienced. Now I'm a bit older. I mainly think of them as being a bit of a scam. One of those things that people try and get you to sign up for so that they can charge you for. And the phone line too. One thing the telephone line was good for was for people trying to call to try and scam you. It's not one thing they mentioned in business classes at all. People will call you out of the blue off advertising. Sounds good, blah blah blah. Keep you on the phone for ages, transfer you over to someone else. And, say it costs so much, which is more than you thought it would be. And then when you go, oh, well, I'll have to think of. Call you up for weeks on end, telling you that it isn't like commercial law where you get a cooling off period. I'm trying to tell you, you don't get a cooling off period, and that they're going to sue you. The thing that stopped them from bothering me in the end was the fact that I told them to contact my solicitor. any sexual scandals and not really being caught out by anything since. Because the idea of being caught by something like that again really push it off. To try and sell as advertising, and you know, at the time I needed customers, I needed affordable advertising, which they try and claimed it would be at first, and I put the prices up. This wasn't some people always assume that scammers are going to be, you know, from an Indian call centre, and they weren't at all, they're from the UK. We're an advertising agency. It's when they started demanding money at the end of the call, and I'm like, I can't sort money right now, I have not got my card with me. And they got really quite aggressive, and then I realised. Like I say, they tried every trick in the book to try and get me to give them money. And it just wasn't for play. Because they didn't have it. It's one thing if you've got the money. All the money I had kind of went into my first pottery business. We bought wheels, killed a lot. Bought a lot of stuff on eBay secondhand. Shelving, but some of it from IKEA, some of it second hand, because I wanted to be able to display the pottery work in different visual settings. And, you know, to do that, you need a variety of furniture. Furniture for the modern had furniture for modern houses and kind of more traditional. It just was what it was. But the day decided to close it, it was absolutely heartbreaking because it meant we'd spent all this money and then you're selling off stuff second hand, trying to claim back a fraction of what you paid for it. the right ones. Research them. Try and go to one. You're gonna go to. You want to trade it. That way you know if it's worth it. And sometimes there aren't past examples that you can visit, but it's one of those things that when you learn it, you know, go out there and look and try and personally, like an open studio. Myself from the house. That was probably one of the more enjoyable, at least on the first day. On the first day it was reasonably warm. Had quite a few busy people visiting, but the second day it was really cold. Really not great weather. The back of that ended up with a massive chest of it. Not last year. Even then, I might do another one this year, but just slightly early. It won't be December. It'll be. I don't know. Probably after the kids go back to school. Spread it through your social circles. Any local art circles. And just get your work out and try things that way. I don't know. Is missing something. I can't quite place it. Let's drop some more shadows in. Thanks for watching.